intruding. I'm one of the co-directors of the Bard Profession Program, along with Eric Tabic, who you'll hear from later. I'm also the composer of the first piece, and I wanted to just tell you a little bit about it to help you into this piece of music. It's all of the music on the program tonight. I'm going to look to make sure. Definitely. It's all 21st century music. Most of this has been written in the last 3 or 4 years. It's all very new music. And this piece is also very new. In fact, this is only the second group that's learned this piece of music. I wrote a series of pieces called Nine Numbers, and they all come from Sudoku puzzles. I really love patterns. I really love kind of mining numbers and words and different structures for to kind of find patterns. And once I got into Sudoku, it's just everywhere. Anybody do Sudoku? Anybody? I saw some vibe over here that was cool. If you don't, it's all good. I wasn't into it so much, and then I discovered these patterns, and it's really wonderful. If you don't know about Sudoku, Juliana, help me out here. You know, it's a series of numbers, and there's nine that go across and nine down, right? It's a 9x9 matrices, and the rules are that you can't have the same number in any column or row. And there's also some fun rules about the boxes as well. So you have a 3x3 box. It also can't have any of the same numbers. So it's just a lot of fun patterns. And the way these pieces work is basically you get the score, and it says, solve a Sudoku. And then it says, take the first line of the Sudoku, and whenever you see in this case it's a 9, play this pattern. And whenever you see an 8, you kind of build your own piece of music. So this was a really fun project. These are the first folks besides my group that learned it in this way, and they actually never looked at the score. I just taught them the piece by rote, and they put together their own version of it. You can choose any instruments. They chose this really, really pretty cool setup. Yeah, it's unlike any version I've ever heard before or anything I could have cooked up in my head. I'm really, really happy that these fine folks jumped in with me on this project. I stole Juliana's part because what they're looking at is just this Sudoku score, the Sudoku numbers, and everything they play is going to come from this set of numbers. The pieces, I wrote 9 of these pieces. They go from solo all the way to nonet. So this is the sextet version. It's called 9 Number 6.
This is
a
solve
the
puzzle.
Is
a
puzzle.
The
puzzle
is this
is
a
puzzle.
The
puzzle
is
this
is
a solve
the
Thank you. plays in a percussion duo with Annie Stevens, who teaches at Virginia Tech. So with her playing in a percussion duo, it's just kind of natural to create her music, similar to how Jason's created his pieces. So this piece is called Vacillating Compass of Indigo and Teal. And that just refers to when she was composing the piece, she had these different ideas in her mind that kind of flip-flopped between the material she was working with. And the instruments in the piece that you're going to hear, we have marimba, kick drum, vibraphone, glockenspiel, and amglocken. And amglocken are these cowbells that Roddy is playing. And another advantage of percussion music when a percussionist composes a piece is that because we're actually playing our instrument, we know kind of what the cool aspects of our instruments are. So as such, these pieces, they kind of fit pretty easily in the hands. And these are just, the patterns are sort of metric manipulations, and just kind of things that would fit naturally as you're playing your instrument. So I think we're almost good to go. So this is Vacillating Compass of Indigo.
Thank you. mentioned to all of the other teachers, fellow like Matt mentioned, we're really excited to get to perform this week for free. Everyone here works really hard in preparing this stuff, so we really appreciate you guys coming out and supporting us. The next piece you're going to hear is part of a larger work by composer Gabriela Ortiz. One of the cool things I think the percussion studio does here at Bard is in the fall, everyone presents it on some composers, from composers from typically underrepresented communities. And this is the composer that I just presented on the fall, Gabriela Ortiz. While I wouldn't call her music her music underrepresented, she's been commissioned by LA Phil. She's had lots of great pieces being performed by great groups. I think this music was really cool, so I presented on her. We found this piece. This piece was commissioned by Stephen Schiff, who's teaches percussion at the University of California, San Diego. And when I first heard this piece, I thought it was like very reminiscent of like John Cage's Reconstruction. It has these kind of textures that happen in it. But what's really different is that the music kind of, it happens in small chunks, but there's larger structures in it. So there's kind of like small pieces of music within those larger chunks that you'll hear in a second here. So this movement, the entire work is entitled Liquid Borders, but this movement is entitled Liquid City. The other two movements, Liquid Desert and Liquid Jungle. Liquid Desert is performed in the same setup, but Liquid Jungle happens and it has four rooms. So what we're gonna perform for you here tonight is the first movements, and I think we're almost done setting up, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you for coming out.
Thank you. Jason, who spoke at the beginning of the concert, I'm the other co-director of the percussion program here at Bard. So that first piece on the second half here is a piece called Sunday by Shelley Washington. Shelley's an awesome young composer who, so Jason and I are not teaching at Bard. We play in a percussion quartet called So Percussion. In our quartet, a lot of what we do is work with composers and help to bring new pieces into existence. We get to do that at Princeton University. Composers in their program. Now, there, Shelley is in that program, but is also a super in demand young composer. She's a very sax player. And, the piece Sunday is sort of meant to invoke the feeling of a Sunday afternoon. You know, some of these lines she was describing walking down her block in Brooklyn on a Sunday, just sort of feeling that easy energy that you have when you don't quite have to be anywhere in particular. And I love that piece. You can really feel it when you listen to it. But yes, please check out other Shelley Washington work. And I also want to give a special shout out at that piece to Matt Overbay, who you heard from earlier in the concert. Matt has been one of our teaching fellows, along with Christian Zavala. And we are sad to say that he's going to be going next year. Oh, yeah, there he is. He's going to be Dr. Overbay very soon. He's going to be coming. Thank you, Matt. We're really lucky to have these amazing folks who come and are teaching fellows in our program. They sort of learn how to run a percussion studio by being here and working with our students, being kind of leaders in the studio. So Matt and Christian, we owe a ton to them for helping keep everything organized and running smoothly. And anything that is running smoothly tonight is definitely their responsibility. Anything And then, I also just wanted to give a shout out for this next piece. Also Juliana Maxmas. This is her last. Although, I would say, please come back on May 20th because there's going to be an awesome recital in here with some like amazing sculptures and things like that that are just going to like totally blow your mind. So May 20th, put it in your calendar now. We're going to be back for that. But yeah, so this piece on the evening, I'm actually super pumped to say that this piece is the first time that Bard has gotten involved in helping us commission a new piece. So thank you to Frank Corliss for helping us to figure out how to get creative with the financing that Bard could kick in some money and be part of this consortium that we organized with So Percussion to get a bunch of folks together and commission a piece from this awesome composer, Kendall Williams. Kendall's an amazing steel drummer. So he grew up in Crown Heights, Brooklyn, but very much in the Trinidadian scene that was there. And brings a lot of his experience playing steel drums, especially in this piece, not just the steel drums, but also it's called the Engine Room, which is like the group of percussionists and drum set players, but also playing all kinds of drums and any percussion you can find that is sort of like the backbone of any massive steel band. So when you go down to Trinidad, there's this thing called Panorama, this like massive competition, hundreds of steel drummers on stage at the same time, which is incredibly loud. And so the drummers have to play super loud and super together to keep all of those musicians on stage organized. And they can do these things where they, for example, like speed up and slow down hundreds of people together all at the same time. It's like the most incredible thing. And Kendall wanted to bring that energy to a piece just for percussionists to kind of try to bring that energy on stage. So we're going to try our best to recreate that tonight, and super pumped to do that. So this piece was commissioned during the pandemic and had a Bard premiere virtually on Zoom. With stitching it together with edited videos, but this is our first time doing it live. So this is Kendall Williams, Walk, March, Run.
Thank you.